Are you a Beatle fan?
Yes.
Let me talk with you.
No!
No, that's all right. You're caught now. You a Beatle fan?
Yes.
You know where the Beatles are?
The Beatles, one of the most electrifying names ever to hit show business. Here on Hollywood Star Newsreel is a dramatic, candid look at these incredible entertainers. Not for one minute will we try to explain this phenomenon, but here is the remarkable proof of what they did to Hollywood, a town that lives with the brightest stars in the business day in and day out. This is Los Angeles International Airport, besieged for hours with thousands of teenagers waiting for their idols. Their effect on Europe and America, almost unbelievable. A special press conference has been arranged. It will go on as scheduled, but certainly not as planned.
Great, we've got a house to go to. I don't know, I just thought I made it up.
This is the home at 356 St. Pierre Road in Bel Air, where the Beatles are living during their stay in Los Angeles. The gates are chained and padlocked to protect the privacy of the mop-haired quartet from Britain. Although the location was supposed to have been a well-kept secret, somehow scores of teenagers managed to find out where the Beatles were staying.
You know where the Beatles are?
Mm-hmm.
Where?
Bandit Canyon.
Where?
Bandit Canyon.
Bandit Canyon?
Yeah.
Where in Bandit Canyon? Oh,
just the rhythm of the rock and roll music. Any old way you choose it. It's got a backbeat, you can't lose it. Any old time you use it. Gotta be rock and roll music. If you wanna dance with me.
A couple of miles away on Avondale Avenue in Brentwood, the streets are barricaded on either side of the home where the Beatles are to entertain this afternoon. But once again, the teenagers have somehow found out where their idols are going to be.
Bandit Canyon.
Where?
Bandit Canyon.
Bandit Canyon?
Yeah.
Where in Bandit Canyon?
I don't know.
The party is being given by record company executive Alan Livingston. It's a charity benefit for the Hemophilia Foundation. Show business personalities are paying $25 apiece, so their children can meet the Beatles, shake hands with them, and have their pictures taken with their idols. It's a big treat for the Moffats of Movie Land on this afternoon of Beatlemania. Here's Hedda Hopper, hat and all. Without her, no Hollywood party would really be complete. Here's Edward G. Robinson among the early arrivals at the party this afternoon.
See the reaction of the audience. I think that's even more important, I think.
How are you, Ross?
You're a Beatle fan, huh?
Yeah.
Are you?
Yeah.
Got the records?
Yeah, a couple.
And they made two great pictures. So I guess they're great.
What do you want?
Well, what are you going to do in there? Groucho, are you going in to listen to Beatles?
I'm going in and get drunk.
You wouldn't dare. Are you really?
Of course I am.
Brought the charming family with you?
Whenever I can get a free drink, I'll go anywheres.
You bet your life.
Yeah. That's a very funny answer.
Here's John Forsythe. He's brought three children with him. For the kids on the outside, police barricades and fences don't dampen their enthusiasm.
It's kind of a lot of money to spend just to go away because they're sleeping.
How much money have you spent so far?
Well, we spent about $110 just today. And we went over the house a couple times, and I think we woke them up, and it annoyed them a little bit.
The Beatles, that is.
Yeah. And the servants came out, and they told us to go away, that the Beatles were sleeping. And, well, it was, you know, at about 10 o'clock, we came down here where we met you. And we took off and we went over there. Rather, I went over, and the other three girls drove with you over in a car. And it's worth it if we get to them. We're willing to spend another $100 if we can just see them. But
they can't see their idols, but their reaction to them